My dear brothers and sisters, happy feast of the Holy Family. And we know that there are families. We see God the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit forming a family. Today we see Jesus, Mary, and Joseph forming a family. You as your children, husband and wife, forming a family. Our parish is one family. And there are good families, bad families, notorious families, terrible families, families that cannot be included, families that should be excluded. We box people as a family with a title. That family is a very pious family. Don't go and disturb that family. That family is really an exemplary family. And we also have the families that form, like parish family, choir family, youth as a family, children as a family, teachers as a family. We take any group, they are a family. What is a family? A family is where one is in authority and the others are subjected to them. That is a family. One's authority is the parents, and the children are subjected to them. Therefore, we see that the unit family is a very important unit or a cell where you grow. That is why parents are the first teachers, they say. And what we heard in today's second reading, the last part, wives be subjected to your husband. Terrible, no? Wife be subjected to your husband. If you ask me, Father, how can this happen? Why should wife be subjected to your husband? I would interpret it this way. For the husband, what is the most important subject? Wife. So he is always there to know that the wife is the most important in his life. It is not being subjected to the husband, but rather for the husband, the most important subject is the wife. And the wife who is the mother of the house is the most important for the children. And therefore, don't look at a negative part of what Paul wants to say. Wives be submitted or subjected to the husband. Rather, you are the most important. God has created male and female, and he made them equal. But for the woman, he has given that tendermost part, the perseverance part, the loving part, the caring part. Husband is one who is a breadwinner. Husband is the one who brings authority. But at the same time, he performs his duty for the family. And the children, we know that they are subjected to their parents. Therefore, when children have to obey their parents, that is one of the important virtues for them. Even now, you have to be obedient to your parents. Why? Because they are the only one whom we can listen to. I can't listen to somebody else. I can't call somebody mommy or daddy. I will call my mommy and my daddy as mommy and daddy, and I will listen to them, and they are my authority, and I will give perfect obedience to them. And if you are able to give that perfect obedience to your parents, my dear friends, you will be respected. And you will give that respect to everyone. So that is the most important aspect in a family. That I will be obedient only to my parents. And once I am obedient to my parents, my elders automatically I will respect. My teachers automatically I will respect. Because the ingredient of obedience is grounded in me. When I am obedient to my parents. Now, what makes a holy family? When we look at Jesus, Mary and Joseph, they call only Jesus, Mary and Joseph a holy family. What makes a holy family? Now if you look into today's first reading, it's a very beautiful reading that gives everything about a holy family. It says, whoever honors his father atones for sin, and whoever glorifies his mother is like the one who lays up treasures. Honored father will be gladdened by his own children, and when he prays, he will be heard. Whoever glorifies his father will have long life. Whoever obeys the Lord will refresh his mother. Obeys the Lord will refresh his mother. O son, help your father in his old age, and do not grieve him as long as he lives. It is important for us to know, if you want to be a holy family, if you want the title holy in your family, this is necessary. And if you look into the life of Mary in today's gospel reading, the life of Joseph in today's gospel reading, it is a reading of the presentation of Jesus in the temple. And they had to do what the law had to tell them to do. They obeyed the law. Therefore, obey the Lord and he will refresh your mother. And now they take Jesus into the temple. And there, they were marveled at what Simeon said. But at the same time, when Simeon said, a sword will pierce your own heart, Mary accepted it. Mary acknowledged that part. Now we look at what Mary did all through her life with Jesus. Till the end, she was there with Jesus. Even under the cross, she was there. And then we see Joseph. Joseph was so disturbed, he said, it is better to divorce my wife. How can I take her? She is already pregnant. And he decided. But when the angel came and said, do not do this, he obeyed the orders of the angel. He accepted it. And therefore he did what the angel said. He took Mary. That was not the end. After that, he had to search for a place, and not finding a place, they found a cattle shed. And after that, the angel comes and says, take the Mary and the little child to Egypt. And they, on the donkey, they had to travel from Bethlehem to Egypt. And living there for a few years, they had to come back to their own town. Why did they come back? Because they registered their name in Nazareth. And therefore, Joseph was directed by an angel to go back. And again they traveled from Egypt to Nazareth on a donkey's back with a child and Mary. Joseph had to do that. Therefore, we see that what Joseph has did and what Mary have done is because of that they are called a holy family. If you look into the life of Abraham, Abraham had to do what the Lord had told him to do. In obedience, he went into the promised land. He went. He did not say, no, no, it is very difficult. And the Lord promised him generations. And then he says, sacrifice your son. Abraham takes the child, Isaac, onto the mountain, and there he obeys God. And then you find the life of Abraham, how it was blessed. He becomes the father of faith, and that is why that family is a holy family. Similarly, we find in the Old Testament, everyone who did and obeyed God and who followed the instructions of God became a holy family. Taking even David's life. David's life was also a very important part because he was chosen from being a shepherd to a king. But in the meantime, his life was terrible. He committed a terrible sin, but still you find that God purifies him and makes him a holy family, so that he can be the most beautiful and the best king in the Old Testament. That is why we see Jesus called as the Son of David. So we know that every person who obeys God the Father, it's not only that, you as a family can become a holy family. How? Yes, my dear friends, it is not important that everything that I do for my family is necessary. The first thing is that you obey God. Once you obey God, you will experience that God is blessing you and your family. You make God the center of your family. You see that God can take entire control of your family. You might be working, you might be earning, you might be building houses after houses. You may have wealth and property, or you may be very poor, no food. But still, have God as the center of your life. And if you are able to do that, you are a holy family. Now when we look at the aspect of how Jesus makes his family holy, is when he says, when they were in search of Jesus, when he was lost, Jesus said, "Do you not know that I am busy with my Father's business?" Look at Jesus. Even though he has Mary and Joseph as his parents, he tells them, "My priority is God, my Father. I have to be obedient to him. If I have to be obedient, then automatically mommy and daddy will become holy, and therefore, do you not know that I am busy with my Father's business?" So you and I have so many things to do in our lives, for our family, for our children, for their career, for their life. We have to get them married and thereafter settle them. So many things you have to do as a parent. But do not lose God in between. If you have God and obey him, automatically your family is called a holy family. "No, Father, but you see, our life is terrible." Pope Francis very clearly says, no family is perfect. No parents are perfect. No children are perfect. No husband is perfect. No wife is perfect. Then what are we supposed to do? Keep God the center of your life. And how Mary could say yes to the Lord and then obey, so also you and I will learn to obey God the Father, and thereby automatically I can make my family a holy family. Today, my dear brothers and sisters, you may be a perfect family or not a perfect family. Strive. Struggle. See that you have God, the first person in your life. See that you have the second person, your husband and wife. See that the third person is your children. And then you will experience Jesus, Mary and Joseph in your life. Amen. Let us all stand for the creed. Let us all together.